Alright, so I'm going to show you how to create a threaded pipe type in Revit. So let's create a new project. Let's go here and use our standard mechanical template. And our new project is created. Now all our pipe types live down here under families. So we navigate all the way down to pipes. And then these are our pipe types. So right now we only have chill water and standard. Let's take a look. Let's go here to type properties, and under the routing preferences I'm gonna go to edit, and here we see what we're using. We have for pipe segment we have copper, elbow, you can tell that it's just a generic standard. The preferred junction type is a T. We'll talk about that in a little bit. A junction is a generic standard. Cross is generic standard. So everything's generic here. Okay. What we want, I'm going to show you in another project that I have here open. Under pipes, I have several pipe types here, right? So let's take a look at the one we want to create for this tutorial, which is a fire protection threaded. So let's go to type properties, and you'll see that under routing preferences we have very specific pipe fittings. We have for pipe segment we have steel, carbon steel schedule 40. For the elbow we have a threaded malleable iron 150, class 150. For junction we have a reducing threaded class 150 as well. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take a snip of this, and then this is what we're gonna be aiming for. Okay, so let's go back to our previous project, which is out of the box, right? And let's take a look at what standard looks like. Okay, so if we go here and we start generating a pipe and we use as a pipe type the standard, let's go ahead and, you know, just draw a little bit and see what happens. Let's put this to fine first so we can see our pipe, and as you can tell these are just generic elbows with generic T's. What we want though is me keep a fire protection threaded, and let's go to say 1 1/4. So this is what we want, right? So if you click in this elbow, this is a threaded malleable iron elbow class 150, right? And if you were to turn this, let's say we upgrade this fitting into a T, then this T would be a reducing T threaded malleable iron class 150. So if you were to reduce this, let's say to 1 inch, this T here would be the same family, is the reducing threaded malleable iron class 150. Okay, so it's a pretty nice a setup that we have here. So let's try to mimic it in our new project, right? So let's delete that standard pipe that we had previously created, and let's go from scratch. Let's just duplicate this standard, let's rename it, and let's call it AJS threaded, right? We go to type properties, and then here under routing preferences is where we specify the stuff that we want. So let's start with our pipe segment first. We said that we were going to use steel, carbon steel schedule 40. Now let's pull out a little cheat sheet here that tells me which You got to do this prior, right? Based on your company specific standards and specifications, you need to look for which fittings you prefer to use and make a little list. Once you have that list, this is what we're using to create this pipe type. So for my elbows, so currently we don't have the elbow that we want available in this project. We don't have it loaded here. Thankfully, Autodesk placed here a load family, and it launches directly to the to your family library. Okay, they're typically located under C, program data, Autodesk, Revit, whichever version of Revit you're using, libraries, US Imperium. Okay, so we're gonna go here to pipe, and then under pipe I'm gonna change my view to list, and then under fittings you have the different types of fittings. So in this case you go under malleable iron and then look for teeth, class 150, threaded, etc., and you would be selecting from there. To make it a little quicker, what I did is I have here under fittings little shortcut here by pipe types, which I created, and then this is going to be our first tutorial, threaded, and then our second tutorial, grooved and threaded, and then we'll do flange and we'll do the others. Okay, so let's start with threaded, and here I have my AJS elbow threaded malleable iron class 150, right? So I click on it and just like that it has been added here. So for which sizes do we want this? Well, let's say we're working now with small pipes. It's a half inch and all the way up to 2 inches. We'll look at different options later. For now, let's just keep it with small pipes. Then here under preferred junction type, we'll keep T. Later on we'll talk about tap. As a junction, I'm going to select the, oh, actually we don't have the threaded T yet, so we have to go back to load family. And you know what, we could load all the families at once. There we go. So now under junction we have instead of the generic T, let's change it to the one we want, which is the T, the reducing T, that is malleable iron class 150. And then for cross we're gonna select something similar, and then for transition we're going, I like to put my initials at the beginning. Probably you would like to have your company's initial so that you know it's a little bit easier to sort your fittings. And then lastly our union, and then for flange we'll talk about that a little bit later as well. But for flange we're going to keep it as none now, because we don't want anything in between the pipe and the and our fitting itself. You'll see it clearly once we jump into the flange section. And then lastly for our cap, we're going to select our AJS threaded cap, which is also malleable iron class 150. So it seems like we're set. Oh, one thing we need to check again is our size ranges. Obviously if you keep it as all, it will work for any size, but what we want to do eventually is to have a combined pipe type or routing preference that will allow us to do threaded pipe for small pipes and groove pipe for larger pipes. So let's go in that direction. So let's select here our range from half inch all the way to 2 inches, and then we'll do the same for the crosses, and then finally transitions. And unions. And then our caps. So we're all set. And now let's start drawing pipe and see how it came out. So our pipe type, we need to select the one that we just created. Let's keep a small size. Obviously, what do you think is going to happen if you go with a larger pipe? So if you try to draw a pipe and you select a larger size that is outside of the range that you specify, and you want to introduce a fitting, nothing happened. I'm clicking, it's just not letting me. See, Revit is not letting me because it doesn't have a fitting to place in there. Right now we only have pipes defined, fittings defined for small pipes, for example, one and a half inch. So if I try to do that now, I have no problem, but so it seems like we have a little bit of a problem here. Why would this be happening? We still have the generic elbow here. Maybe we didn't change it. Let's check. Exactly, so that's what's happening. The elbow still is the generic standard. So let's place the right elbow here, which is the AJS threaded. And the pipes that you already drew are gonna stay like that. But any new pipe that you create using that pipe routing preference is now going to have your new threaded elbow. The same way, if you introduce a T, now you have the threaded T that you were looking for. If you want a reducer, let's say we want to reduce to 1 inch here, you have a threaded reducer. And also, if you want to join two pipes, by default you're going to have a T as opposed to a tap. So this has been how to create a pipe type, a threaded pipe type, using Revit MEP. If you enjoy the video, make sure you like it, and you subscribe if you want to get notifications. Hit that bell, and I'll see you in the next video.